some content about what we getting ready to take at KBC. 140,000 transfer exchange for Bitcoin, and actually take that Bitcoin and buy 230 some thousand KBC. It's gonna be real quick, real easy. Well, easy for anyone. Let's take this and move on. I don't want the echo. We can just move that somewhere. So I want y'all to see that the value that we're giving content here through Curve Bars, Mr. Sites has done it continuously. You can turn the volume down. Give me that. This is crazy because we just today, right? Three days later. I don't know if some people even understand what took place, but July the 4th, 2019 was the first time in history that any cryptocurrency was physically exchanged for gold. Real gold. Y'all see that? Real gold. This is crazy because nowhere in history any crypto ever been exchanged for real gold. But right here with Curve Bars, and we are the first to make that happen. Man, I'm just ecstatic, blown away. I got Bitcoin Lou here. I got Gil here. And we blown away by what's took place. But just even more blown away about what we're going to show y'all. That's some valuable information that's going to help change your perspective, change how, you know, you need to see things. Listen. You don't need cash. You need gold. You need an asset. You need an appreciating asset. If you want cash, go out, share your business, tell more people. Man, you got the whole world. You'll make a whole lot of cash by doing that, but no value. Man, Mr. Delco said it, I think it was yesterday. He said, we know the price of everything, but the value of none. Do y'all understand this is valuable? The moment, the time that took place in history, July the 14th, is valuable. You will never, ever be able to go back in time and say, I was a part of that, if you ain't a part and you wasn't here. So, I don't want to, you know, preach to the choir. I ain't trying to get you, beg you, want you to do nothing you don't want to do. But what I do want to do is try to help y'all understand the value and having an appreciating asset. Not leaving your money underneath your mattress, between your pillows, I don't know, in the shoebox under your bed, in the safe in your house. Maybe even if you got it in a 401k, a mutual fund, an RA, an annuity, whatever you got it in. If it's US dollars, it's dying. A money marketing, a CD, it's dying. 2.8 to 3% eating up your money every year, every day. It's eating, it's getting ate up. But if you got appreciating asset, it grows in time. And if you put and place some money into one of our vehicles, which is an ICO or KBC coin that's on exchange, it grows exponentially, real quick, real fast. I mean, it will blow your mind. So listen, real quick, I'm gonna show y'all this. And so here, I'm showing y'all this guy we sold, and let me back up. Let me back up so y'all will actually be able to see the whole process. So you see here, right? This happened on the 27th of June. 148,000 KBCs. It was put in as a limit order. But and as you can see, I had to cancel it because all didn't sell. Matter of fact, 68,649,000 KBC coins didn't sell. Now, we end up turning around and selling them, right, which is no problem. But I want y'all to check this out. This is crazy. It's bananas. Bananas. So, we bought it, sold it for Bitcoin. We took the KBC, sold it for Bitcoin. And so, the Bitcoin showed up as a whole Bitcoin, 1.05. And here you go, $11,069 worth of Bitcoin. But then the day, a few minutes ago, we took that same Bitcoin and we exchanged it and transferred it. I want y'all to see the number, 1.054. With fees and everything, it showed up here as 1.04. Now I want to show y'all something that's going to blow your mind, because this is like phenomenal. So we're going to take that Bitcoin. Now, again, you've seen it. 148,000 KBC coins was enriched. 148,029 KBC coins. And here you go. That's what we started with. That's what we took and bought Bitcoin with. And now we're taking it and we're going to bring it over here on Yobert. And then I'm going to show y'all the deal. Y'all want to see the deal? Of course, you want to see the deal. But this will blow your mind. Hey, all y'all that's listening on Facebook, Instagram, I don't know where you at, Worldstar, YouTube, MySpace, you pick something, wherever you at. I want y'all to know that this is what we're showing you right now. It's going to blow your mind. But I also want you to know, I want you to find me on Facebook, Instagram, you know, YouTube, Crypto Steve. Like, share, and please share the videos to your team, your family, whoever you want to know that know about crypto. Use it for a tool to market for your business so you can make money. How about that? So here you go. Real quick, I'm going to show y'all. So the Bitcoin is here, and if I want, we could sell the Bitcoin for, oh man, look at that, 1213. So automatically, it's 11,000. Look what it is here. It's 11,000 in Curbit. Just a couple of minutes while it's moving a little. So look, it's 11,069. We bring it to Yobert, it automatically. Now the numbers doesn't change for how much Bitcoin, but the price changed. So what I want to do, I want to take the money out, the profit out. So here you go. If I'm taking that same Bitcoin and I'm selling it, and I'm selling it for $11,650, I'm making about $600 profit. Look at this. So let's click here, and you see $12,135. If I wanted to do that, it would be awesome, right? Let me go here because it's going up as I speak. It's moving too quick. So look, here you go, bang. If I wanted to do that, $12,208. If I wanted to do that, I would take that $12,208 and watch this. $12,208. You see it right there. I know some of you don't see it, and I'm gonna move pretty swift, but regardless, if I had $12,208, right? That's how much I have, and I wanted Bitcoin, and I'm paying whatever this price is for right here, right? Let me go back and change this number again. 1220208. That's 240 KBC coins. Y'all see that? That's almost 100,000. What's that? 92,000? 92,000 coins. Profit. We ain't talking about money. We're talking about profit. 92,000 coins. KBC coins. Now let's do this. Because I know. Let me do it. Go ahead. Because this is crazy. Lewis is being calm right now. But he just losing it. He on there now trying to make a sale. I mean, trying to do some transactions. I already know. So here you go. Let me hit this. It's moving kind of slow. We're not going to worry because we're not going nowhere. Because money needs us. We don't need to go nowhere. Money going to find us. And it's going to say, hey, come join me. Come use me, Steve. You know I need to be work. And so money need to work for us. So here you go. Even if I take the Bitcoin, if I don't exchange it for USD, right? Because that's what I showed y'all first. I'm going to keep the Bitcoin as it is. I'm going to go here because this is what the price is being sold for. And I'm going to click here, Bitcoin. And guess how much I'm going to get? 228,000. right? That's still over 48. So what's that for? That's 80,000 KBC coins. 80,000. But I think I'll take my chances in taking the USD. So we're going back to USD. We're going to sell the Bitcoin to USD. Take the USD and buy KBC. How about that piece? So here it goes. That sounds good, right? Let's do that. So here it goes. Selling the Bitcoin is 1172. We're going to take and sell this whole Bitcoin. And it's going to be 1208. So let's do that. Bang. Now I know it's going and sitting for a little bit because nobody's trying to sell. Let's see. So we're going to wait a little bit. We're going to keep it here. Go down. It's moving kind of slow, but hey, watch this. Even if I want to take it, we just sold. Trying to close out, but I got to make the screen small. Okay, it's done. So listen. All right, so let's do it for 6, 7, 11. Bam. Sold already. We're gonna keep it here. We're gonna see this numbers change. This is bananas. So Lou, you got something to say, Bitcoin?
Well, basically, man, this is the thing we've been talking about from the beginning. You know, this is what we've been trying to help people to understand the potential in the KBC coin and what you can do with it. As far as like Gil right here, he made a move that we've been speaking from the beginning. You know, he had a chance to move some of his coins from one place into a whole nother coin, which being a Bitcoin, right? Bitcoin rose in value, and it rose so much that now we're transferring the Bitcoin, selling the Bitcoin to buy more KBCs, and you're coming up over what is it, 95,000 KBCs?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you do the math. I mean, and that's when you actually, you know, you invested. I'm not saying that, like, you're not looking at your business or you're not, you know, paying attention to your business, but actually when you're in, side of working your business, this is the kind of things that can happen for anybody. You know, mm-hmm. A lot of y'all don't know. I mean, shoot, Gil got a full node and 2 master nodes. So we're not talking to somebody who is not just, that's only want to have, hey, when can I sell my coins? You're talking to somebody who's taking a vested interest in growing his coins as far as what we've been talking about the whole time in wealth building. That's how you build wealth. You don't build wealth at the slight, as soon as you see something has a small pulse move, and then you want to run to the hills and quote unquote cash out. Now, there's a lot of people been cashing out over this weekend here in Las Vegas at the slot machines, tables, and all of that good stuff. People been cashing out, right? But I'm gonna tell you, this is not that. You know, we're building wealth. We're not just out here to try to make a couple dollars, man. I mean, that's one of the hardest things to get across to people. And, you know, really look at where this company is going and what they have to offer and what's on the table right now, not to mention the other things that are coming. This is where you build your wealth. And I've never ran into somebody who was on their job, you know, for 3 days, and the next thing you know, they're asking the HR department, hey, you know, when am I going to get my money back for my 401k plan? You know, they don't even have it. No, you're not even vested in your 401k plan for at least 5 years on that match. You know, 4 to 5 years, you're not even vested. So, look, sit back, relax, take a breath. Let's build wealth together like this man is doing right now. See, when you get in a position where you know you want to build wealth, your mindset is on building wealth, that's what happened. And that's why we're sharing this live stream with you right now. Because Bill Steve making this thing happen. Owen sat back with his hand on his hip, not doing nothing, right? Just watching the money stack up. So listen, I'm done unless Steve want me to say something else later on, but I'm getting off the scam.
I mean, I think you said it, man. It's just crazy that people are willing to sell an asset so quick and so easy for so less of a price. a value. You know, you're willing to give it up for something that's devalued, which is cash, because you got a temporary fix you got to fix. I promise you, if you take the cash out now and fix the problem that you think need to be fixed, or whether it's a bill to be paid, a mortgage to be paid, it ain't going nowhere. Because you're not fixing the problem. The problem is you. And I'm not trying to get on you. I'm just trying to get you to understand. Stop looking at an asset as a liability. Start looking at it as an asset. Start looking at your bills, your problems as assets, and start saying, what can I do to create a passive residual income? And it's crazy because Mr. Earl Sykes just gave us the opportunity. He not only gave us every opportunity, he gave us everything he's making money from. So watch this. If I had my hand out and I had pennies, nickels, dimes, quarters, silver pieces, and gold pieces, what would you take? What would you take? Would you take the gold or would you take the pennies? Would you take the nickels or would you take the quarters? What would you take? If I had my hand out and I got pennies, nickels, dimes, quarters, silver, and gold in my hand, what would you take? I know most of y'all gonna say, I'm gonna take the gold. And the gold is, I promise you, the gold is awesome. I'm gonna take the quarters. I'm gonna take the silver, the dollar pieces. I'm gonna take all of that. But listen, guess what I would take? Everything. Everything. If you got your hand, if Mr. Sykes said, here, I'm taking everything. Give me everything. I know some of y'all are not gonna get that. But that's cool. You have the opportunity to win big in this company and not sell your asset for the value price. You don't turn around. If you own a $300,000 home, you won't take it and sell it for $100,000 because the market value say $300,000. And if you will, then something is wrong. And we need to go back and evaluate.
That's right. And see, the thing is, we want to help correct mindsets so that you don't feel like taking everything is something wrong to do. That don't have nothing to do with being greedy. That don't have nothing to do with taking something from somebody else. Man, look, when it's laid out in front of you and it's yours for the taking, take it all. And what I mean by all? What I mean by all is expect what you expect, what you inspect. You want to make sure that you're looking at, what am I actually doing here? You know, what am I doing? Am I just trying to make a couple dollars or am I actually really building wealth? If you really got the mindset of understanding what building wealth is all about, you're going to do the necessary things to be involved in your business, plugged in, know what's going on for yourself, and then you'll get into that mode where building wealth is something that not only you want to do, but it's something that you're willing to share with other people. That's what it is. I say it all the time in this business, in this crazy, this industry, everything that we're in, most of the people don't know a hill of beans about cryptocurrency. They barely saving any money anyway, you know, and for the most part, none of the people have ever saved their money in gold. So a lot of times when people don't understand something, you get a little apprehensive. And all we do is say, look, we already know that when you come into this thing, you're at the highest level of anxiety. We know that. We already know it. And you're at the lowest level of knowledge. We know that too. Mm-hmm. We understand that coming through the gate. All we want to do is help close that gap.
That's right.
So that you can have a working knowledge of learning how to build wealth in this business. I mean, and it's really that simple. Once you know that, once you understand that, look, this is a wealth building thing, if you haven't been in, somebody left you some money or you were heir to some wealth already, if you haven't been, now's your opportunity, it's your responsibility to be that person in your family to leave somebody something in your will instead of leaving them alone. Because that's exactly what you're going to do if you don't prepare yourself to build wealth. You're going to leave them with all of the reasons why they won't do this and won't do that. And, man, that's just the facts, man. I love this opportunity. I love this business. We could be doing 1,000 other businesses out here, people trying to get us in every kind of business you can think of on the planet. You feel me? But, man, we chose to plant our flag here with Carabars, and we've done that for a reason. Because success leaves clues. And one of the other clues is, man, when you got successful people, that's already successful in their own right, in their own businesses and everything, and they decide to come over here and build in this business, that's a clue for somebody. That's a clue, man. What my mama say, you better check yourself before you wreck yourself. Come That's on, just man. A fact.
Come on, somebody.
Sherry Brown.
That's right.
So, and I'm going to tell you, man, it's the facts. It's the fact. It give you that freedom. What do you say about that freedom that Mr. Best talked about?
Yeah.
Mr. Best, Ty Best, the best at it, man. He talked about that freedom. Man, Mr. Best said, man, the boy ain't know his mama.
That's right.
You understand what that mean? Mr. Best was saying, man, his mother, look, his wife was working so much, man, her son didn't know his mama. How many people in that situation? I used to be in that situation. It felt like when I was getting up, going to work when it was dark and coming home when it was dark. I leave the house in the morning, my daughter in the bed sleeping. When I get home at night, she was asleep.
Mm.
How many of y'all dealing with something like that? How many of y'all got more month at the end of your money? You know what that means? Man, we just got to do something about it. And like, man, kicking the tires in your own business is where it starts, man. Understanding what's going on and don't act like Chicken Little, thinking like the sky falling. Because you see the price of the coin going down. Man, that's God giving you the opportunity to buy some more
coins. Buy more.
Man,
buy more.
They ain't got the door.
Yeah.
And if you got some gold, I'm going to say this last. I'm going to say this. I ain't going to say this is going to be the last thing I say. There's no, ain't no telling. But I'm going to tell you like this. If you got some physical cash gold, right? You got some physical cash gold or some of the classic gold, you got it sitting at your house. If it's bothering you that much, I will buy it. Reach out to me. Reach out to Steve. We will buy your gold back. We're working on a plan right now. If you want to sell us your gold, we'll take it. That's another clue. That's another clue. We'll take it.
We'll take it. So, you know, we finish. I'm actually working through the numbers now to actually have all this. And you'll see it come through. Only thing I got to say, man, I don't know if Gil got anything to say. I most definitely want him to share his story. But, man, maybe you can tell him what you started with, what, you know, the 140,000 and 148,029 coins and how you turned it into a Bitcoin and what we're going to get. So, and we're going to show him exactly how much we're going to get at this
end. Well, we used Bitcoin to get those coins in the beginning back when the last year with the KBC when I got in the company, and we just sitting back waiting patiently, and once July 4th came, we decided to go ahead and switch those coins and buy the Bitcoin and watch the numbers shift. Didn't panic, not panicking. This thing is going too good for us. We've been watching it, and you gotta have an investor. You either have a debtor's mindset or an investor's mindset. You gotta make up your mind where you're gonna be. Hmm. If you're gonna be there, that's what we're here for. That's the type of people we like to run with. But if you have that Chicken Little panic, can't work with you. It's just plain and simple. It's too many good things going on with this company. And I've seen it. I've seen it over the last year and a half, 2 years. And then not only that, myself, I'm looking at my circle, my friends, my family. And I'm seeing so many other people lining themselves up and patiently getting in position to become multimillionaires. Not just millionaires, not just to pay off a little debt, right. But multimillionaires. Right. And then I'm seeing mothers opening up accounts for their children. And their children's children, and just putting in and just being patient. You know, July 4th was just a date. Again, we have our whole lives to build this whole company. And these brothers, everybody coming around, it's too many good things going on. It's too much good information, and it's too many. I mean, if you would have been there last July 4th in that building and seen people from all over the world, international people, I mean, it all kind of business walks. Everybody there excited about carrot bars. It's not a fluke. And there's no way, I mean, it's just no way that everything, all this panic and everything that everybody's, don't listen to it. Just don't listen to it. Listen to those that have your answers, not your problems.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And if you think anybody in here to not make money or to make their money work for them, then you messed up. So just because you don't see it, maybe you don't understand. How about that? You ever thought about that? Maybe I don't understand the whole piece. But it's just crazy to me that so many want to take, and I'm not saying it in the point to nobody, but so many calls, so many people want to find a way to cash out. Man, listen, you're trying to cash out when you know it's going to be a gram for each coin. Why would you sell the thing that can get you freedom for a quick fix?
Go buy a pizza.
Yeah, go buy a pizza.
Go buy a pizza.
Hey, so, hey, I don't know. Again, I'm just excited about where we at. I'm just somebody just trying to just help people understand the value they have. It's the reason why Lewis and I had actually stopped buying and really stopped focusing on our real estate just to build this company, man. You're going to make more money. We're going to make way more. And we're going to make, let me put it like this, not just more money. We're going to make so much profit here that it's going to be unbelievable. Because not only are we going to build this to China and back, I promise you, but even just having the opportunity to have the coins, the first ever cryptocurrency coins that's backed by physical gold that we just exchanged for real physical gold. Nobody has done that ever. Shoot, they ain't even done currency. U.S. dollar, none of that since 1971 has been exchanged for real physical gold. Again, I gotta show y'all this, man. This is real gold. Real gold. You see that? That's real gold. We ain't talking about the fiat paper. You burn that disappears. You burn this, that gold in the middle is still there, baby. It ain't going nowhere. This is crazy. So, Mr. Seitz and his team said, hey, we're gonna do this for the people that love the fiat. We're gonna create cash gold. So now they got value. So now, if the paper disintegrate, the gold won't. He said, for all those that still hung in the 90s and the early 2000s, that love the credit cards, the e-wallets, we're going to he's created CurrentPay. So now you can electronically transfer real gold to pay somebody. And then they can take that real gold digitally, electronically, and take it and cash it out for fiat. Never fiat. For real gold, fiat paper with gold in the middle. It's called cash gold. This the new fiat right here. This it. It's called cash gold. It's got gold in the middle. The new fiat. That's what you can exchange it for. And then he said, for all those that's thinking about the future, let's go with future of money going. We're going to take this and we're going to take it and have the first cryptocurrency backed by gold. And by the way, for all you skeptics, all you think that KBC and KCB coin and GSC that's coming out, that ain't backed by gold, July the 4th, 2019, we're going to take every 100 KBC coins. We don't care what the market say. We're going to give you 1 gram of gold for coins that's not market-wise not valued at that. But look at the value. Look at the point of what he's saying. It's valued at a gram. Whether or not the market said it or not. Y'all got to catch that. Y'all got to catch that, man. Market have nothing to do with you having real physical gold, a gram for 100 coins that's not even worth the gram. But because the value of the coin. And because it's the future of money. Because Mr. Seitz said, I'm helping you think ahead. And what we're going to do, we're going to give you 1 gram of gold. And here you go. We exchange this. This is actually 10 tenths of a gram. It's the fiat, what we call fiat with gold in the middle. That's what it's called. Cash gold, baby. That's it. Cash gold. We exchange crypto for cash gold. We exchange electronically, current pay. You can actually exchange it and load it back into your back office and have it shipped to you in cash gold. That's unbelievable. That's bananas. And so you have an opportunity to be a part of that. And whether or not it's something you want to do, it's cool. with me, I mean, reality is we got millions of coins right here. So we don't care what you do. Reality is you can do whatever you want to do. We don't care.
You can do whatever you want.
Whatever you want. We already there. I mean, you know, we're trying to help you get the value of what you have and not sell it and devalue what you have. So, that's, you know, we're excited. We're excited. And we're here to help anyone that need help, for sure. And let's make this thing happen, y'all. Let's do it. Let's do it. So I'm working on this last transaction. My computer is moving real slow, so. Okay. That's the only problem we have right now, is just moving real slow. Not bad internet out here in Vegas. We're still in Vegas. Me, Lewis, and Deal, our other partners, went back this morning, but. Man, it's just a phenomenal thing to be a part of a company. I was sharing with a guy earlier. A lady put me on the three-way with a guy. He said, if I'm going to invest, I'm going to invest in my own company. He said, why would you leave your business to invest in someone else's dream? I said, because my dream ain't big as this dream. I got a big dream, but this guy already started it. I can't go out and buy gold mines. I can't be the largest gold distributors in the world. He's already there. Mr. Seitz already had plans for the future of where the money is going. He's looking at the future from a global economic point of view. I only can see it from my point of view. This guy has seen it from the world's point of view. Why would not partner with someone who have the idea, who wrote a book 2 years in advance saying the future of money is cryptocurrency? And then the government, July 18, 2018, enter into the laws of Congress in the Federal Reserve that cryptocurrency is the future of money. And then this company jumps up on the Forbes list as number 7 blockchain in the world to watch out for. Why would I want to? I don't have that. I'm going to partner with that. I want to screw the money. I'm talking about being partnered with something huge. Listen, I love the idea. My name written on the wall in Stuttgart, Germany. Me and my wife on the wall, one of the first 100 people. I love that. That's history. History. That's all it matters. The money gonna come when you're a part of something that's bigger than you. Man, I feel like I'm saying too much and I'm doing too much, and I don't want to do that. So hey, I just want to let y'all know that, you know, if anybody that you know that's watching this live stream, if you haven't seen what we have or you haven't really took a look at it, stop being closed-minded. Stop walking around with your eyes closed before you walk into a ditch. Open your eyes. See what's happening in the world today. And if this is something you want to do, then if this is something that you want to be a part of, you want to be great. You want to have money working for you. You want to live the life you want to live. Be who you want to be. Create the designed lifestyle that you want to create. Man, we've been to Dubai. We've been to Barcelona, Spain, Frankfurt, Germany, South Africa, Cape Town. The safari desert in Cape Town. Played in the Lions Den and all that. In the last 3.5-4 months, that was all paid for by Mr. Pearl Seitz, Kurt Bars International. And you asking me, why wouldn't I partner with this company? I would be a fool not to. I would be a fool not to. And I'm not saying you're a fool, for the Bible said, a fool have said in his heart, there is no God. I'm not saying that. I'm just telling you, whatever you desire to do, you can do whatever you want, because we straight. You know. So let me just go ahead. I'm waiting for this last one to go through.
Where we going next year? Amsterdam.
Amsterdam. Woo! Am I going to be there? Yes, you guys will believe that. I will be there. So we got so many different opportunities to be in so many different places in the world in the next couple of weeks. This is crazy. It's bananas. In the next couple of years, man.
Passport,
Rolex is coming. Mercedes Benz, we getting all that for free, man. This stuff is bananas. Like, come on, man. This is like something like, man. It's like, I can't even explain. I can't explain. I'm just excited. Yeah, it's happening. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes I sit back and I think, man, you know, when Dorothy in Kansas clicked the hill three times, man, is this real? You know, so anyway, I don't know about y'all. We are in for a ride. So we're going to go ahead and I don't know if anybody else want to say anything. This whole opportunity is going to be because it was so many. Oh man, here we go.
You gotta always think about your why.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta think about what it is that motivates you and whatever it was that brought you to this point in life. And you gotta look and see who's involved. And when you look at the character of the persons that have involved and the length of time that they're doing what they're doing, it can't all be just puff. It can't be puff. Just as he was saying, we're talking about people who are businessmen, business persons that were making millions of dollars, and they come back and take a second look at this. And looking at the rate of return and the amount of work in running a business and running your own business and building up. And not saying that you can't run your business, but you gotta always have more than one iron in the fire.
Because
when the fire go out, what you gonna do? What can you fall back on?
Matter of fact, man, I don't wanna keep throwing out scriptures, but if you look at Ecclesiastes 11 and verse 2, it talks about having your money. Seven places, if not eight. You know what I mean? So when it comes down to what we're doing here with Carabao's, even inside of the Carabao's ecosystem, there's multiple streams of different levels of income that you can position yourself in front of. You know what I mean? And build yourself through the power of leverage. I mean, we got so much leverage going on, it don't make no sense. Always, I know within the union, our team union, there's a Super Saturday going on in some marketplace all around the country. You know, we have a weekly business briefing. Actually, we got one going on tomorrow night in Largo, Maryland. You know, there's the webinars, you know. Even things like what we're doing right now, which was just impromptu. We was in the room talking about some stuff, and we felt like, you know what, we need to share this. You know, so with the webinars, the daily webinars, training webinars that's going on tonight, you know, actually probably going on right now, East Coast time, you know, different things that's going on, you know, you can just plug yourself in. Find that thing that you can actually lock on with to help grow yourself, grow your business, help take you to the next level. So you can be more effective, even when you're communicating what this business is all about. You know what I mean? So, man, I mean, that's all I really got to say, man. I love this opportunity. I love the fact that we're allowed to even participate in this opportunity. You know, I say it all the time. Most things like this, they want you to be accredited. But right now, man, Carabao's opening the door for you to position yourself in front of something that's actually groundbreaking and historic. And for that, man, I'm truly grateful. That's all I got to say, man.
Thank you, Mr. Sykes, and your team. Thank you, Ovidio. Thank you, Mr. Heights. Thank you, Alex. Thank you, everybody that's in leadership. Mr. Dalbo, Ty Best, for sure. Thank you, guys. Thank all the leaders here in Carabao's and Mr. Seitz and his team, all Thomas, Marcus, all y'all. We appreciate y'all. Thanks for being leaders and just continue to share this opportunity nonstop and believing in yourself and believing in your dreams and believing in what God gave you to make your mark here on this earth. I think that's very important, and I believe that God created us for a purpose and plan, and I believe your purpose and your plan makes a mark that cannot be erased. And so we appreciate y'all. Thank y'all for everything again. And with that, man, I'm...
Take care. Take charge. God bless.
Peace. And I'm going to go ahead and jump on.